Portland's transit system is, for lack of a better term, is a fare proof, or proof of fare, proof of payment system. Basically, you only have to pay immediately to get on a bus, to get on the MAX, which is our light rail, or to get on the streetcar, which is a streetcar in downtown. You don't really have to pay to get on. There's no like gates or anything. You just get on. And they trust that you have paid. So every once in a while, you'll see transit officers on trains. And by every once in a while, I mean, I've lived here for 4 years and I think I've only been carded for payment maybe 10 times. And I ride a bus or the MAX almost every day. And it's odd. It's an odd system. I'm not gonna do another time lapse there, at least not for a week or so, but water pools up right there really easily, so it's always gonna be a good spot. But my gosh, look at this clouds today. So what is going on, friends? Hope you are having a great day today. I'm having a pretty okay day today. Today's vlog is going to be a little bit different because I'm gonna need to be sitting at a computer to do it. I got some things to talk about, and it's mostly about the theme of self-awareness, and mainly self-awareness online. Something I've been thinking about a lot lately. Self-awareness is kind of my mantra, I think, is being aware of your surroundings and what you say and what you do and who you say it to. So we're gonna talk about something, so settle in, I'll be right back. All right, here's the thing. I had this big long spiel planned out that I was going to say, you need to be careful the way you leave comments for people's videos on YouTube, and I had this whole list of things planned out to say, and then I realized that that wasn't, like, very positive. So we're going to go in a completely different direction. In the words of Philip DeFranco, now for something I love today, brought to you by this green linen shirt. He always sponsors an episode with a shirt that he's trying to sell on, like, Teespring or something. Some things that I love today. Basically, this is just going to be some shout-outs. So if you don't really care for shout-out videos, then, you know, just hope you have a wonderful day. Peace. Be good to each other. See you next time. Sorry, my mouth is dry. Got that cup on a cruise. Fun fact. My friend Jordan and Katie. Jordan and Katie. They have a vlogging channel, K and J Day by Day. They got engaged last week, or the beginning of this week, or something. And Jordan actually vlogged it. And it's awesome. So if you have any inclination to see people being happy, being in love, or you like Disney, or all of those things put together, it's just an extravaganza for you. Go check it out. It's in the description below. The next thing I love lately is my friend Amin. He is a vlogger from Vancouver, British Columbia. He is on this new awesome journey to help YouTubers and to help Instagrammers basically just become the creators that they want to be and the entrepreneurs that they want to be. His videos lately have been super inspiring and awesome. So, Amin, thanks for what you're doing, man. I really appreciate it. I love watching your videos, and I'm really looking forward to being able to hook up with you when I'm in Vancouver in July. Third thing I love today is a channel that was pointed out to me by my friend River of Rivenal, some vloggers friends from Chicago, and he pointed me to a channel that many of you may have seen before, a creator by the name of Peter McKinnon. Peter is a vlogger slash filmmaker slash photographer based in Toronto, and he is an absolute wizard when it comes to
artsy things, the filmmaking side of this YouTube thing that we all love. And he does color grading, he does After Effects, he does Premiere tips and tricks, he does things with music. And I feel like he and I could really share a really good cup of coffee, because we both make really bougie coffee, kind of a lot of the same ways. Just seems like a really fun guy. So Peter, if you ever see this, thanks. Your work is very inspiring, and I really appreciate what you're doing. The next to last channel that I love today is a channel that I've actually just gotten reacquainted with, because it was one of those channels that was disappearing from my feed, and I actually went manually through all of my subscriptions to see who I was missing. And that's Ryan Wilkes. Ryan has a channel called The Path Less Traveled, and Ryan is originally from Canada, and he is doing some doctoral study. Ryan, leave me a comment, correct me if I'm wrong, or postdoc study of some sort. He lives currently in New Zealand and is traveling around New Zealand. He's into photography and videography and filmmaking, and his drone skills are amazing. And New Zealand is just a beautiful place. And we hear a lot about Australia. We hear a lot about Southeast Asia. New Zealand is not a place, at least my circles and the things that I tune into. I don't hear a lot about New Zealand. So anytime I tune into Ryan, it's always really informative. It's gorgeous. New Zealand is just staggeringly, breathtakingly incredible. So that's something I love. Ryan, actually, I think he just hit a thousand subscribers a few weeks ago. If you have some time, go check out Ryan on The Path Less Traveled. One more, I promise. Hold on. The last one that I want to talk about today is a channel called The Endless Adventure. The Endless Adventure is a married couple, Eric and Allison. And I started following Eric and Allison. They were actually one of the first like vlogging channels that I followed. Let me put the phone down now. And Eric and Allison, I think I started following them, and they had something like 250 subscribers. And this, at the time, I think I had like 20. And I was just in awe. I was like, holy cow, these people are traveling around and they're doing such cool things, and people are actually wanting to watch their content. This is amazing. So I subscribed, and since in the last year, Eric and Allison have absolutely exploded, and they just hit, I think they tweeted today that they hit 15,000 subscribers today. Basically, their mantra is just living the adventure, and I know that there are a lot of channels on YouTube living the adventure and, you know, kind of following in the footsteps of Fun for Louie, but these guys are doing it, and they're doing it well. They're doing it authentically. They are providing valuable content, which is something like that a lot of vloggers just don't ever get over that hump where they wonder why people don't want to watch their vlogs or why people don't want to subscribe to them. And the simple answer is there's nothing to pull people in to keep them there. If you're not offering anything of value, you better be one heck of a good vlogger, have an amazing personality, have amazing editing skills, and have amazing video and all audio quality, because other than that, there's really nothing to keep people glued to your channel. Eric and Allison are offering not only amazing personalities, amazing video quality, amazing audio quality, amazing travel locations, but they're offering value because they've been to so many different places, they've seen so many different things. Everywhere they go, they make guides for specific cities. They're just offering tremendous value. They're giving you a reason to stay on their channel and to stay connected to them. They're active on Instagram, they're active on Twitter, and they're uploading a lot, you know, multiple times a week. And that's something that really stands the average vlogger out from the really good vloggers. And Eric and Allison absolutely get it. They're very good at what they do. Check them out. All of the channels that I mentioned today, I'm going to put in the description. Go give them a subscription. Let them know, hey, you're doing an awesome job. Let them know that I sent you. And yeah, I'm glad I decided to spread some positivity today instead of rant about something, because you don't need to hear that. It's Friday. I hope wherever you are, you're having a wonderful Friday. wherever you are, whoever you are, I hope you had a wonderful day. Find someone you love. Tell them you love them. Peace, and be good to each other, and I will see you next time.